it's Fran in the lab, yada yada. And I've got another cool video about something that many of you have probably used, or at least seen, or maybe not. But there was a time, not so long ago, at least not in my timeline, where numerical registers were largely mechanical. And I got a tray of really cool binary coded decimal switches, which were sort of really ubiquitous back in the day to act as mechanical registers for numbers to input into all kinds of equipment. And well, let's take a closer look. All right, here we go. I've brought out Big Iron, my real Nixie power supply. Uses an original StanCore transformer. That's a 150 volt transformer, and it's got its own DC supply because I'm using the 6.3 volt filament supply. I've got a regulated 5 volt off that, so I can run the things like Nixie drivers, like I have on here, those 5 volt Nixie drivers, and also I have the DC output for 200 volts. 200 volts. Okay. And I've got my little Nixie module here hooked up, little national Nixie tube, and a little driver down there. And hooked up to it, I've got this little thumb wheel BCD switch. They look like this. It's pretty simple. It's you know, it's got a FR4 board on one side. You can see the switch contacts etched into the top there. It's just like you'd see in a multimeter, if you've ever seen a multimeter tear down. It's got a ratchety thumb wheel with this little spring in it, which makes it so that you can only rotate it in one direction. If I try to push up on it, it won't go. I can only push down. And this just changes the contacts to give us four different outputs. You got a common in the middle there, and you got four different outputs, and those are labeled 1, 8, 2, and 4. Those are the bit outputs for BCD. Oh, there we go. Yeah, 1, 8, 2, and 4. And those create the BCD output. 4-bit nibble. Isn't that a cute word, nibble? Byte is, of course, 8 bits is a byte, and half of an octet, or 4 bits, is called a nibble. And I love that word, a nibble. And I love nibbles. I'm a big 4-bit BCD fan. And I've always loved these very simple and easy to use little thumb wheel switches. Sometimes these are called encoders, although I wouldn't describe them as such, but they are really, they are definitely a form of mechanical memory. So you can actually connect these together. They've got little pins that allow you to stack them up and keep them in register, and you can put bolts or these screws, you know, right through the whole block, and you can stack as many as you want to make strings of 4-bit numbers as long as you want. And you can dial in whatever kind of number you want, and that will remain in memory as long as you don't flip the switches. Now these are thumb wheel switches. They do have another version of this they call push wheel, which is basically exactly the same thing, only instead of having the little star-like, you know, little thing where you flip it with your thumb, it's got a switch, like a little push switch on the top and bottom, and you can push up or push down to change the number. It's the same thing inside. It's just you got a push button instead of a little thumb wheel. But I absolutely love these, and I've hooked one up here to this Nixie tube. Let me plug in Big Iron here. All right, so I've got one on the thumb wheel, and I got a one on the Nixie, and I'll flip it. Oh, we got 2, 3, 4, 5. Got a little reflection here, but it does say 5. 6. And you see how fast it is, too. 7. 8. 9. And 0. So, yeah, they're just so easy to use. And I just love these for, controlling anything BCD. I'm going to get a close-up of the Nixie since we got it on. Take the opportunity to get a beauty shot. Here we go. Oh, yeah. 1. Oh, yeah. Nothing like having a real Nixie supply. You notice that there's like no blue haze in there. It's not purple or anything like that. I mean, it's just a real solid 200 volt supply, which is what you want, thanks to big iron. okay, so I've got like a whole tray of these. I got surplus. The great thing about these thumb wheel BCD switches is that they still make them. So, which is really unusual to have like this very 1950s mechanical type of memory input that's still manufactured. These are C&Ks, but I bought them surplus. If you go on Mauser or whatever, they really charge a fortune for one of these. I think I looked up on Mauser like almost like $60 for one of these or some ridiculous price, but you can get them surplus for, you know, next to nothing. I know I paid hardly anything for a whole tray of them, so they're very haveable. And if you do anything with 4-bit, you know, BCD, binary coded decimal stuff, I really recommend having them around. I'm gonna power down the big iron, and I got plenty of these, so I figure I can sacrifice one for a teardown. It's really just held together with a little rivet, so I'm just gonna drill that little brass rivet away. Looks like it's gone. Ah, there we go. Well, it didn't actually pop off there like I hoped. Okay. Well, it did come off anyway. It's just got like a button snap thing, so yeah, I guess that just, Oh, I see. And these are just kind of melted over. So let's see, I got a... people who watch my channel, they know how much I love to use chisels. Yep, nothing like a sharp chisel. Because it's, you know, it's better than an X-Acto because you've got a really firm edge. And if you keep them sharp, like razor sharp like I do, then, you know, you just give a little nudge and you can cut through anything, pretty much. And always push away from your body. Never push towards a hand or a finger. That's just like the old stories when I used to work in a rental shop. Stories about like the guy who sat a log over his leg to cut it with a chainsaw. Yeah, you don't need a video camera to know what happened with that. All right. Ooh, this is actually pretty interesting. Let's take a look. Let's see. So this is, got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wipers all tied together. And that goes on top of there. And that's the BCD out. And you got some of them going through. They got some vias in there, or vias. Taking two of them through there. Oh, and the common, too. The common goes right... Oh, see, there's the common goes to the center pin. And the center... Oh, okay. So that's it. So that's taking the... That's the common right there, rotating around. All right, and so the common gets it to the top, and it and there's your BCD. Your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. Yep, okay, cool. And then you got a little window here, which fell out, and then just the wheel. Pretty simple. That's everything you got inside of a BCD switch right there. All right. Well, that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. thanks too to all of the amazing people down on the Patreon who make everything work at Fran Lab. That's why I'm doing this. I'm only really able to do this because of all the support I get on Patreon, keeping the lights on and yada yada. And so if you like this video or any video I make, then consider becoming a patron. Just follow the link in the description. I will thank you personally. All right. I'm Fran. I'll be back here in the lab with something else real soon. Bye! In the lab. That's where I work. In the lab. Go berserk. My lab, it's where I work. Watching Fran Lab, it's what I'm doing, working at the bench again.